you can use the electrophilic saturation normally just at the two position or three position. If the this two position was blocked, and then you have chance to introduce group to the five or six, but it's quite very difficult to give you the four and the seven subunit. So therefore, if we want to make this kind of seven subunit indole, the Bartholin indole synthesis is the most popular approach. But now we have the CH bond activation that's ready. So it's our the hope to use this kind of strategy to introduce the bunker at the seventh position. The problem is you need a suitable directing group. So in the previous study, people already tried use this kind of acetyl protector indole, and they always give this kind of two substitute that product. That's because this kind of during the CH bond activation, you have this kind of five member ring intermediate is favored. This kind of seven member ring is intermediate is unfavored. So the idea for us is quite simple. Once we change the size of this function group, maybe we can change make this unfavored intermediate become the favored intermediate. And therefore we found that just simply use the pure protect that indole, and then you can introduce the function group selective radio selective at the seventh position but not at the two position. So this kind of methodology is quite simple because the directing group can be easily introduced and also removed. So another thought I want to show you is just this is just the three class of the alkaloids. One is the communism and another one is the coxia, and the third one is acromine alkaloids. So their structure is quite different, but they all share a common character. This is the cautery carbon centrate this position, and also fused that indole ring system. So for synthesis, three classes of the alkaloids, we just developed a new strategy. This is the intermolecular de-aromatic octave coupling of the indole. The study just show you here that if you have this kind of starting material after the phase treatment, you will have this diene intermediate. So after oxidation of the diene intermediate, you will have this diuretic. The diuretic react each other, give you this kind of spiral indole system. If you start from this kind of starting material after the base treatment and also audition, you can have this kind of fused ring system. If you have this kind of structure and after this similar transformation, you have the spiral and fused ring system. So use this methodology, we just successfully finish the two things of the communicating F. You can see here, we can use this intermediate. After the audio copying, we can have this kind of spiral interleaving. Later, we use this kind of bridged amide as a study material. After the audio copying, now we have the kind of spiral interleaving. Use this intermediate, which is the communicating K. Later, we just try to build up this, the second type that intermolecule octave coupling, that is between the indole moiety and the maroid moiety. So this study actually work well. So after the coupling, we were able to obtain this kind of the fused ring system. And so you can see here that in this reaction, we got a two quarterly carbon center at this position. After we have this intermediate, we can since it's the one current, quite easy. So later we also tried this kind of audio copying. Now we have this kind of hypercycle intermediate. So we use this intermediate, we get finish the two things of aspect of filling A just in 14 steps. This actually is our third type that audio copying. That is between this ketone and then also is indole moiety. So after audio copying, you will not only obtain this kind of kinetic density, but also give us this kind of imine. The imine can be used to install this kind of amino ether by using Stryker type reaction. So why we need more extensive synthesis? That's actually if your target molecule is useful, and then the more extensive synthesis is very important for prepare the target or make some new analog. So here I just show you an example. It's just a very famous beta anti-flu drug. Right? One is the Tamiflu, and another one is the Zanamivir. So after a long time we use the Tamiflu, we already caused the Tamiflu resistance trend. So therefore, in recent years, several groups are working to develop some potent inhibitor against the autoimmune resistance strand. And so you can see here the sum of the structure just showing here. But in their synthesis, they all use salic acid as a starting material. So if you do the medical chemistry well, you know immediately realize so the modification room for this kind of strategy is quite limited because the structure already fixed. So for us, if you look at the structure, they all have this kind of 1,2-diamine moiety. Therefore, we try to use this character to develop some more extensive route. Just 7 years ago, we found if we use this kind of organocatalyst microhydration between this alligator and this special natural olefin, we have this kind of intermediate. After 6 more steps, we can synthesize the Tamiflu. So this kind of chemistry already scale up in the kilo scale. After that, we try to use this kind of next special natural olefin and starting material. Use another type of that organocatalyst microhydration with the acid. Now we have this kind of product. So we use this product ready with this aldehyde generated from this very cheap sugar. We were able to obtain the xanamine just in 13 steps, 18% overall yield, just in gram scale. So it's quite good, much better than the previous reported that synthetic route. So more importantly, now we have this kind of very convenient strategy to make the xanamivir and also the xanamivir analog. So you can simply start from this kind of substitute that natural compound or the aldehyde. You can build this kind of cool structure. After several steps, we can synthesize some new xanamivir analog. So we already found some very interesting compound from use this strategy. So just recently, we found another that converted the strategy to synthesize the intercurrent terpenoid. So this kind of terpenoid family contain more than solvent that the members. They all share this kind of the structure. So. During the past 50 years, many groups involved in the synthesis of this kind of natural product. So, but for us, we just developed a very convergent data route. That is starting from this kind the origin and the aldehyde undergo a home other reaction, we can have this intermediate. After the Nakayama macro reaction, we are able to obtain this key intermediate. After that, we can transfer this key intermediate to two that natural product. One is the lysine B. So I don't have time to give you detail for the synthesis, just show you the key reaction. The first step, first key reaction is just the home other reaction. The intermediate just showing here. Because this kind of collision, the aldehyde will attack, this nucleophile will from this side attack this aldehyde, and it gives us the home other reaction product. So after we have this intermediate, we just simply treatment this keta with this Lewis acid. So then the reopening of target was this very reactive the intermediate. So in this part, we have the enoether. This is has the weak nucleophilic ability. So then this enoether will attack this olefin and give us the C-C bond formation product. So after further transformation, we can obtain this key intermediate. So use this strategy, we can synthesize this key intermediate from this commercial or ketone just in parallel step. So recently we already found that if you use that product methylene analog of this olefin, we are able to obtain the key intermediate. So the key intermediate can be used for synthesis a number of that endocrine that target, and so you can see the structure showing here. So in today's talk, I want to just show you our recent result on the copper catalyst, the coupling reaction of the aldehyde and the nucleophile. This actually is a very important reaction. The general structure just showing here. So if you're working on the methodology development, you always hope that some people will use that your reaction. But probably you're not aware that the major user of our reaction actually is the medicinal chemical. So here I just show you the medicinal chemical, the top of summarized by some research from the company. So they found the hydro atom alkylation and the arylation actually is the number one popular reaction. The second one is isolation and related process. And the third one is protection and deprotection. The fourth one actually is the C-C bond formation. Even for the C-C bond formation, I think most half of the credit goes to the Suzuki reaction. It's about 5%. But even Suzuki reaction actually is the most popular name reaction in the pharmaceutical company. But it's not the number one popular reaction for the metal chemical. The N-arylation is the N-arylate is about 60%. So for the N-arylation with the aldehyde, the chemistry is a very long history. So in the beginning of the last century, the woman and the Goldberger discovered the copper catalyst, the coupling of aldehyde with nucleophile. But for a longer time, this reaction suffered from the use of the chemical that amount of copper and the high reaction temperature. Although the reaction condition is very hot, but it's very useful reaction. So both the academic and the industry use this kind of reaction to produce their desired compound. At the end of the last century, two breakthroughs appeared in this area. One is the Friday has the aberration of the nuclear field. The major player is Black Wood and Hardwick. They found that they can use a catalytic amount of copper plating and the reaction condition quite well, and also the reaction scope is very good. Almost at the same time, several group discovered that if you use the bidentity ligand to promote the copper catalyst reaction, the reaction also could be carried out at the mild condition. The reaction scope is good. You can use the catalytic amount that copper and the ligand to do that catalytic reaction. So this kind of ligand includes the amino acid and phenolphthalein and the diamine and many different ligands. So here, just show you our chemistry. We found the use of the proline as the ligand. We can pair out the C-N bond formation and C-S bond formation and introduce the added moiety to aromatic ring and also C-C bond formation. Since it's the biral ether, we need to use the N-dimethyl glycine as a ligand. So after we publish this result, so more than 1,000 applications appeared for assembling the bio active compound and the material molecule, which include some kilogram scale preparation and also 1 ton scale the manufacture discovered by DSM for prepared printing. Although the chemistry is quite successful, but we still have some limitations for the copper ligand catalyst, the coupling reaction. But one bigger limitation is the relatively intensive aryl chloride, a difficult substrate, which is actually the major drawback in comparing with the Black Wood Hardwick reaction. So even for the aldehyde and bromide, catalytic loading are still high. In most cases, normally it's 5 to 20% of copper salt and also ligand. So although they were quite cheap, but for large scale synthesis, you cost a lot of wire. The third drawback is some nucleophile are not workable for copper catalyst reaction, such as the acetic secondary amine. So for the acetic secondary amine, we all use this kind of triethylamine as a model reaction. Several group include us or tried this reaction, but we always found that the conversion is quite low. Normally it's only around 20%. So at that time we all explained this kind of problem was presumably due to the relative robustness of the acyclic secondary amine compared with the pyrimine and the cyclic secondary. But after several years later, we found that this kind of explanation is not real. And because when we carry out this kind of coupling reaction, this bulk protect the hydrogen, we only obtain this kind of product. That means the coupling occurs at this position, but not this position. This actually is less hindered position. So it means that the electron matter of the nucleophile plays an essential role for this kind of reaction. Of course, when you carry out this kind of coupling reaction, you cannot change the nuclear matter of your substrate, but we can change the ligand. By changing ligand, we can enhance the catalytic activity. So therefore, we just try to develop a new ligand to serve the existing problem. So for us, the ideal ligand should be both conveniently available and easily tunable. If you look at the structure of the Christ ligand, these three class ligand, conveniently available, but it's not so easy tuning for the electron matter of the ligand. These two aromatic ligands, you can use this ligand as starting material. You can easily tuning the electron actor by introducing different substance groups to the aromatic ring. But as you can imagine, the synthesis of this newly designed ligand is not so easy. So they are not ideal for the further development. So just 6 years ago, I read one paper from the chemical Eurojet. It is published by Inorganic Chemistry. They want to make this kind of copper complex to determine the special character of this kind of complex. I don't have the interest to get the special character of the complex, but have a great interest to this kind of reaction. You can see here, just start from this aniline, the one step, you can have this kind of the amine. So it, for me, actually, immediately realized is our ideal ligand for trying the copper catalyst chemistry, because you can easily tuning the electron later by introduce different substances, just start from different anions. And also the ligand is quite easy, just one step you can synthesize. Therefore, we just synthesize this ligand and check if this ligand can be used to promote the copper catalyst relation with the chloride. So, our initial try is quite exciting because we found that the reaction under this condition it worked. And although the yield is not good, but it's already good news because under this reaction condition, the oil-creating ligand are not work. So then we just simply try to change the electron letter of this ligand. But we found that even you change the electron letter of the ligand, the conversion is still low. Like this introduced this kind of three mesosis group, this conversion is almost same. Just occasionally, the student told me once he used this kind of monoamide and monoester as a ligand, and then the reaction yield jump to the 74%. I cannot believe this result because you know this ether is quite sensitive under this reaction can be hybridized to the corresponding salt. So I just asked him to synthesize the carbon salt and found that the reaction still not good. And then I just asked him to isolate the reaction mixture to identify what's the said reaction. And he immediately found that this kind of ligand just react with the coupling partner to give this diamide. So we synthesized the diamide and found that this diamide actually is the real ligand for this kind of reaction. So therefore, we just focus on the different diamide and since more than 300 different diamide because the synthesis is quite easy. And definitely we found that this kind of the barrel substituted diamide with three mesosis groups, we call it the BTMPO, actually is the best one. So you use this diamide as a ligand under this reaction condition, we found that our chloride work well, give us the corresponding coupling product. No matter the electron letter, even the electron power and the electron rich and all work well. Some hater our chloride also work well. For that amine, we found that a number of the different chloramine work well, give us the desired product. So the only problem is the second amine. Even for this very reactive that second amine still give not good yield. Only for the electron rich electron power that our chloride give us a good, if you use the electron rich, and the conversion is not so good. So then we just try the coupling with of our chloride with the ammonia. And we found that after quick screening, we found that this ligand actually is containing a phenyl here and a methyl here, give us the best result. If you use this ligand to promote the carbon catalytic reaction, we were able to copy the hydroxyl chloride with ammonia to get a wide range of the aniline, the structure just showing here. Yeah, if you start from the dichloride, you can stop at the minor amination stage, right, like this product. This kind of dichloride only react at the less gigahundred position. If you start from the hydroxyl chloride, we can obtain the desired the amination product to the yield. So then we just move on application for synthesis of diethyl by copying the R chloride with the phenol, because this kind of diethyl moiety can be found in many natural products and also drug and some synthetic cells. So we use this reaction as our model to screening the different ligands. So interestingly, for the amination reaction, we need this kind of biarrow that substitute that diamine. But for this kind of reaction, we found that this one is the better one. So it contains an R group here, aniline here, and also alkylic amine here. Yeah, so under this reaction condition, we found that the other ligand of field give any conversion. Use this ligand, and we check the reaction stop and the limitation. And so you can see here, either the electron rich one, R chloride, and the electron poor R chloride all work well, give the coupling product include the excellent yield. So also the reaction calling with some functional group like amine and cyan, and also the hydroxy group, and also the different hydroxy group. You start from a different hydroxyl chloride, we were able to obtain the desired coupling product in good to excellent yield. So this reaction actually is quite very important. Just show you some example for the potential application. So just several years ago, the Decoder Genetics developed this compound already into the phase 2 clinical trial for treatment of dog. We already use the old chemistry, that is the copper iodide and dimethylglycine catalyst that bioether formation produce 100 kilogram of this intermediate for get a large amount of this final product. But now we can offer them a much cheaper the reaction to get the same product. Let's just use the much cheaper dichloride as a starting material and use similar coupling reaction, you can obtain this product. So another two example just came from some instead said, this compound I know is was popular use in the worldwide. So for synthesis, this bioether intermediate, the method failure at the German catalyst, the institute developed of a procedure. They just incorporated with Bagusa and Evonik. Make this the procedure to the ton scale manufacturer. In that case, they use the bromide as a starting material and use this as a ligand. But now we can use the chloride as a starting material and use our ligand, almost similar condition, you can obtain the same product. So this actually is well known that inside the site, they will contain this kind of bioether moiety. This procedure was developed by a Japanese company. They still use this kind of catalytic reaction to make this bioether. Now if you use our new ligand, we can carry out the same reaction at a lower reaction temperature, just probably 30 to 40 degree different. You get the same product. So then we just try to use the new catalyst, try the hydroxylation of the hydroxyl and the halide. So actually the hydrolysis of the chloride is it's a known reaction, very useful reaction, already used in industry for producing phenol. It's called the Dohr and the Bayer process. But in that case, you need a very high reaction temperature and to get this the phenol. So it means that the aryl halide can be ready orbiting in great abundant variety, and therefore allowing assembly of phenol and hydroxylate the hydroxyl in a diverse and economic manner. So from a synthetic viewpoint, if you use the aryl halide as a precursor of phenol, you can avoid the use of protecting glue and also make aromatic ring more stable. And during your synthesis, you were able to change the visual selectivity. So this reaction actually quite a useful reaction. But before us, this reaction can be done by using the vanadium catalyst reaction, use a very complicated ligand. But for copper catalyst chemistry, several group already reported this kind of transformation, but they all need a high catalytic loading and a high reaction temperature. Also, very limited to the aromatic and the bromide. So then we just try to solve this problem by using our newly developed ligand, and then we found that if you use this reaction as a model reaction, after quick screening, we found that this ligand is contains the hydroxyl group by the population of amide. It's the best ligand. Later, we just found simply change the copper source to this one, give us a better result. And then use this ligand and also this copper source as a catalyst. We were able to hydrolyze a number of that hydroxyl chloride to the corresponding the phenol structure I just showing here. Yeah, if you start from the bromide, we were able to carry out the reaction at a very low catalytic loading and also just 80 degree. You can hydrolyze this kind of bromide to the corresponding the phenol. If you use the aldehyde, we can further reduce the reaction temperature. You can see here that even 40 degrees is okay. But normally we need a 60 degree to get the complete conversion. So as you can see, as I mentioned in the previous slide, that once the ligand is suitable for the aryl chloride, and then it will give a chance to reduce the catalytic loading for the aryl bromide and the aldehyde. So then we just try the amination with that aryl bromide and aldehyde. So after quick screening, we found this ligand, we call it the MNBO. is the best ligand. Use this ligand, we can achieve the 1,000 turnover for this kind of ammunition with the bromide. If you use the iodine, we can achieve the 10,000 turnover. So it means you use this amount of that copper and ligand, you can get the 40 gram of the ammunition product. So for some difficult amine, like this kind of second amine, we found that if you use this ligand, we were able to carry out the coupling, just use 1% of the copper and 1% ligand. And if you use that aniline, and use this very cheap ligand, you can achieve the change of diaramine as we in the at the low catalytic loading. If you carry out this kind of coupling, also that you can achieve the at loading. So for coupling with the containing cytocycle, we tried to use this ligand. We found that if you start from bromide and this trade condition, only 2% of that copper and this ligand is good enough to obtain the desired product. If you start from iodine, you can use only 1% of that catalyst, and 80 degrees is okay. They all represent the lowest catalytic loading for this kind of coupling reaction. Since it's the bioether from bromide and iodine, we can also carry out the reaction at the low catalytic loading, just use the different ligand. The structure is just slightly different. Yeah, but recently we found that this ligand is a good suitable ligand for coupling the beta-aryl chloride with the amide. So as you can see here, at the 130 degree, we were able to couple a number of amide, including the lactam and carbamate, to obtain the desired compound product, including here. If you start from the bromide iodide, we found that this ligand is the best one. You can carry out the reaction at 80 degrees of the room temperature if we use the iodide. Yeah, also, recently we found another ligand is just the hybrid. The ligand of the proline and this kind of the amide. This ligand is good for synthesis of this aryl from the aryl chloride. If you use aryl bromide iodide and starting material, we can carry out the reaction at the low catalytic loading. So just in summary, I think I mainly focus on the introduction of to use the optic diamond is the new generation of ligand called the copper catalyst aryl reaction. So if you use this kind of ligand to promote the copper catalyst reaction, you can carry out the reaction with the difficult substrate, and that's the aryl chloride. If you use this ligand to carry out the coupling reaction with aryl bromide iodide, you can reduce the catalytic loading to the quite low, 1% or even the 0.1%, and also the reaction temperature is low. So with that, I want to give my thanks to the student for their hard work, also the financial support from the Chinese Academy of Science and the NSF of China, and the Ministry of Science and Technology for their financial support. And finally, thank you for attending.
Good Thank you so much for your nice talk. So would you accept some questions from floor? Yeah? So anybody from floor wants to make some questions? Yeah, this way. Especially students, please make sure you have a couple of questions ready, okay?
Nice talk and congratulations, you are great achievement. So my question is very simple. In case of your allyl chloride, copper catalyzed allyl chloride coupling, you use the amine and alkyl substrate, right? Yeah, so I'd also be to use the this, what's that? Allyl chloride is very important in the pharmaceutical synthesis to for the formation of this kind of bioallyl compound. So usually use the, what's that? Diketone type, right? And like diketone type ligand is green. Diketone type ligand. Ligand. Anyway, diketone MI, anilide derivatives. Anyway, so I really wonder, so why this, what's the rationale to improve the catalytic efficacy of your copper catalyst of this ligand? Do you have any relation?
Yes, yeah,
it's a bilateral ligand.
It's a good question, but we don't have the detail, the explanation, but I think so for this kind of MI, we believe that you know, after treatment with base, the diamide comes the diana. The diana coating with the copper, then make that copper more reactive toward the active coating with the alkyl chloride. I think this is actually probably true. But we don't have the evidence to isolate the intermediate. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Just a minor question. Actually, indeed, I used your chemistry, you know, to synthesize some amide, you know, amine, aniline analog. But I think your example show there's no functionality like ester or lactone. And when we tried your condition to lactone containing halide,
yeah,
we could not get the aminated product.
Yeah, but for some, you know, the complicated that substrate, probably, yeah, this kind of condition is not so good. But I just suggest you try the different condition, like the solvent and the base. So probably you can get the better results. Even for us, you know, for every reaction, we just check the different condition, solvent and base.
Actually, I checked your reference, all the references, and I found that I don't know, your system may not tolerate ester functionality in general. I think, yeah?
Ester is okay.
Ester is okay.
It's okay. It's okay. So the one key point is the copper aldehyde need reactive. Just normally we just recreate that iodine, or sometimes just with the THF to remove the trace amount of iodine. The iodine actually is can inhibit the reaction.
Mm.
Okay, you just tell a student to repute that copper iodine.
Mm. Okay, thank you.
Photosensitization. Photosensitization. Oh, photosensitization. Yeah, I think it's one of our goals to develop the new reaction, but we tried all the different conditions, but it's impossible. Because the fluoride is a weak nucleic. I think we tried to use it. I think that's a very, very important reaction. Just use the potassium at the fluoride. Right, yeah, but until no reaction.
So my real question was, Fred Fu, Jonas Peters, these guys, when they did annihilation CN bond formation, they used the visible light photocatalysis.
Oh, photo?
Yeah, so in your copper system, is there a possibility where you can actually excite the complex so that you can utilize excited space perhaps for the
I think for the proper reaction, probably that's one of the polypro mechanism for the copper catalytic reaction. Mm-hmm. If you use the photon, it means the radical, the intermediate.
I'm asking your system, your
we never tried the photo catalyst, but
it would be interesting if you just examine.
Yeah, but for photo reaction, you go through the radical reaction,
okay.
Radical type of the mechanism. Mm-hmm. But in our case, we believe still the addition and elimination mechanism. Reaction
score
actually, the copper catalyst is quite
a,
much better than the photo
kind of the
reaction.
So, one advantage might be you can do the reaction probably at lower temperatures.
But you use the photo reaction, you still use the iodine or bromine. Yeah, for this kind of reaction, we can turn out that also the low reaction temperature. But the only
any questions from the floor? So, Professor Ma, if you